You are watching Meadcraft with your host, S.O.T. Mead.
Welcome back, folks. My name is Mead, and you're watching Apex Craft. We've got JC and Red Lore on the server tonight.
Woo!
Woo!
Hello.
And we're going to be doing an ME system while these guys babble on.
No, not Babylon.
Babylon.
We'll just talk.
Either way.
Babbling is different from talking.
Sometimes.
I don't babble. Do I babble? I don't babble at all.
Sure, yeah.
Yep,
babbling never... would be just talking without a point.
You never babble.
No.
No.
I drool sometimes, but... Yeah.
Yep. Right.
Yep.
So, are you going all out for your ME system? Are you going to go ahead and make a thingamabob, the assembler chamber?
Not yet. All I'm going to do right now is do the controller and a drive and a couple of the 1Ks and an access terminal.
Would you like me to bring you a 16K?
Sure. I will never turn something like that down.
I have it programmed in to my assembler. I can click a button.
I love that thing so much.
Yeah.
Yeah, I need to get an assembler again.
Look at that. Here's a 16K storage cell.
Of course, having all the materials helps, too.
It does. I need to, yeah, it's gotten bad. I need to run my quarry again. I just did get all of my, all of the ME system hooked up so that I can turn the quarry on. I did find out that you cannot put an import bus or a fuzzy import bus directly on a Tesseract.
Yeah, you've got to have a
chest or something
in between it.
Between.
Yep. Yep. Ran into that problem on the last map.
Okay.
You know what you can do though? You can put an interface next to a Tesseract, an item Tesseract, and it'll work just as good.
Really?
Yep. The Tesseract will output into the interface.
Yeah, because that is considered an inventory.
Yep.
And then you wouldn't have to have an import bus to go on it, so that's okay. That would work.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh, there's trouble.
Yep.
Here's your stuff.
Woohoo! Thank you.
Is this a poop waterfall? What is this?
That's redstone.
Can I swim in it? Oh.
Yes, you can. Oh, yeah, I don't think you can drown in it, actually.
No, as a matter of fact, it would appear you cannot.
And you know the best part?
What?
Here.
Check this out. Goes fast.
Check that out. Bah!
Ha ha. Where does it go?
It's just... What do you mean, where does it go? It goes down.
But...
Look.
Oh, okay. It's just for decoration.
Right.
That's all. It's just for decorations.
Because I was... JC is giving himself stuff because we encountered the gravestone bug, so you'll see a lot of that.
Yeah.
But, I was trying out the barrels, trying to empty a creosote oil barrel in my liquid transposer, and I had a little bit of redstone in there. So I had to top it off and get a bucket. And then I didn't have anything to do with it, so there it is. But yeah, it transmits redstone signal. And
awesome.
if you use the new stuff that I forget what it's called, but it looks at chest inventories and actually looks at the signal strength.
Yep.
This provides a signal strength as well.
Oh.
So the signal down here is lower, you know, whatever, 10 or whatever it is.
Than it is
15.
From the source
yep.
block up there.
Yep. All right, what was I doing? That's right.
Have you seen the Bibliocraft lanterns yet? You should check those out if you haven't.
Are they actually called lantern?
Yes, they're golden lanterns.
I haven't
They're pretty easy to make,
seen.
Too.
I mean, are you talking about the stuff that I've got all over my walls, maybe?
No. Here. Let me cheat one in. I'll show
oh, here it
to
is.
You.
Here it is. Here it is.
Find it.
golden lantern. I see.
There you go.
Interesting.
So here's the trick. If you get, there's an, also a new table in Bibliocraft. You can drop the table down. It looks like a like an end table, I guess. You can right-click your lantern on it, and it will place the lantern on the table and provide light. You can also right-click a torch on the table, and it will place the torch on the table. Pretty cool.
So, like, one of these tables?
Nope.
Sorry, what table were you talking about? I was looking for stuff.
Okay, yep, hang on.
Alright, Tom, I think I got all my stuff. You can be out now.
Alright. Let me get a torch as well. This table.
Well, one would expect to be able to place a torch down and have it provide light.
Like that.
That's pretty cool.
Cool. And then, like I said, you can put a torch on the actual table, though, with a right click as opposed to...
Right clicking a torch in any
like
other
that.
Location?
Oh, yeah, but it's not an actual torch block.
Yeah.
You can also, yeah, you can put anything you want on the table, right.
That's really cool.
So, yeah, there you go.
It oh, that's the whole stack.
Table. Oh, was it?
Yeah.
You know, these tables, the furniture mod tables, they when you put multiples of them together, they become a multi-block. So it moves the legs around, so you only get four legs ever total.
Yeah, the guys have seen that in the past series, I guess. I don't know. Maybe I didn't record that. Maybe I did. I don't remember.
This is the first time I've ever been able to play with furniture mods, so...
Yeah. Cool. And you can hang it from the ceiling. Dude. Seriously.
What are you hanging from a ceiling? Like a muff? Oh, really? I hadn't tried that. There you go. That's pretty awesome.
That is pretty awesome. We may have to raise the ceiling in here just to get a better effect.
Oh. I did not take myself out of cheat mode. We'll fix that. Huh. Awesome.
Very.
Now I'm going to have to rethink my ceiling, too. There's a lot of it.
All right, we have a control. Oh, we did make a blunderbuss as well. I'm just interrupting the hell out of this ME system build.
I've been doing that, too. I was like, I'm going to build an ME system today. And I'm like, oh, wait. Here's all this other stuff I have to do
first.
Yeah, just
build the damn thing already. Ah. I'm sure that's what everybody's saying. But yeah, this is fairly powerful.
Did you shoot a baby cow with it?
No, I shot a larger cow.
Okay. Baby killer.
Yep. But yeah, the shot uses gravel instead of iron.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
Yep, that is too cool. Of course, it looks all, you know, small and detailed and a lot different from all the 16 and 32-bit stuff that's in here.
All the Bibliocraft is like that as well.
Yeah.
That's okay.
We just need everybody else to catch up.
That's right. Well, you know, texture pack. Anyhow. I'm happy with vanilla texture pack.
Yeah, I am definitely going to miss the Ars Magica magic fabricator here for making all the ME cable that I could possibly want.
You know, there's something like that in the Thaumcraft expansion.
Yeah, it's not. It doesn't only make the Thaumcraft stuff though. I think it does.
No, No, I think you can. You need Thaumcraft aspects to run it, but I'm pretty sure it can make anything. But I haven't personally tried it out.
Oh, that's right. That's the one that it costs a heck of a lot more than you get back out of it.
Probably.
Like what I did with the Minium Stone.
Yeah. So I tried that once long ago. He may have changed it, as Norm may have messed around with it, but
You think of a furnace? I don't think we've had a server with the expansion on it, the Thaumcraft expansion on it for now.
I have not.
Yeah, the last time I played with Thaumcraft was probably 3 or 4 months ago.
Yeah, I think the mod is newer than that, but I don't know what you played around with, I guess so.
What? No, Thaumcraft has been around for quite some time.
No, not Thaumcraft, the expansion.
Oh, I see. Okay, I missed that part.
Thaumic Tinkerer.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that one's fairly new.
It adds some really cool stuff.
All right, we're almost through with the basic system.
A meat packer, awesome.
Yep, for making meat cubes.
Yep.
Edible meat cubes, or edible meat ingots. And you can carry them around in cubes. It's pretty cool. More stuff to lose.
Yeah. So for a mine factory reloaded farm, I'm going to need a planter and a harvester, yes?
And a fertilizer. Fertilizer is kind of optional, but I highly recommend it.
Okay. For the sake of keeping my boilers fueled...
You'll want a fertilizer.
Yes, you will. But you'll only need... I mean, once you get it up to temperature, you'll only need, like, 2 cows.
Cows? Oh, I've got to do that whole deal.
Yeah.
Oh.
But, I mean, that's easy enough. It's a sewer and, you know, the composter, and then... But the rate...
It's like 5 episodes to do all that and all by itself.
Yep. But the rate at which you get charcoal back is... Because I've got 2.5 stacks extra now. And it's just kind of station keeping. And I'm not using hardly any energy. So on one level, that kind of freaks me out that I'm wasting all that power. But on the other hand, it's like, well, it's all coming from nothing. So it's running my entire place is running on cow poop right now. So we're good.
All right, so then I'm also going to need a rancher to do the cows, right?
No.
Oh, no. We're going to have to go look all that stuff up.
What?
No, just the sewer.
Yeah, just the sewer. You just need a couple of cows to sit there in the dark.
Oh, really?
And poop.
Okay. In the dark. I'll give them a light.
Fun fact, the sewers also work when players move on top of them. So, basically...
I always wondered where my Minecraft avatar went to the bathroom at.
Yep.
Apparently he just holds it.
Holds it until he finds a sewer. And it's like a crap explosion.
Somebody needs to write that mod. Post haste.
Yep. Crap craft.
Crap craft.
Crap craft.
Toilet craft. Crap craft. There's some other 4-letter words that start with S.
Yeah.
Okay. Controller, I think I'm going to get put... Yeah, the access terminal is going to go over here.
I would highly recommend taking your access terminal and turning it into a crafting terminal.
Oh, yeah. Definitely will be doing that. But don't believe I have... Well, yeah, takes another golden chipset. I'll do it later. It'll be fine. Now, I almost don't like the crafting table, the crafting terminal, just because it doesn't show you as much of the items that you've got as the regular one does.
Agreed.
Yeah, I wish they'd change that.
Well, it would be nice if it would depend on your UI size.
Yes, it would.
Yeah, that would be good.
And the sewers need to be plumbed, I assume. Liquid ducts.
I think it does take a liquid duct in between.
Right.
Making a right mess of my ceiling. Two more. There we go. Functional ME system. 12 units per tick. That's, oh, that's probably because I've got all those drives in there. That seems higher than it used to be, though. Something may have been altered.
Yeah, I think I heard that they did increase the power requirement.
Well, that's fine.
We're also using a default config. I've not tuned the config any, yeah. So.
Well, that's fine. We've got plenty to go around. Now I can start moving stuff over. Yay! I need to go find some ender pearls and get a few deep storage units. So I won't burn everything up with cobble. Actually, I wonder what the partition editor. Oh god, it costs another golden chipset. Good grief. Alright. I guess we'll go get a few more of those, if you don't mind, Joel.
Yeah, no problem. I got plenty.
Yes, you do. And it beats having to make my own assembly table. King Slime, what the hell? What are you doing over here?
Me, nothing. That thing just spawns.
Oh, okay, no problem.
Yeah. Don't mind that guy. Just the King Slime.
So, while we're on the subject of Star Citizen...
We were, just before I started recording.
I learned something today about the citizenship cards that we got. They're not just for looking good.
So,
if we end up or go to one of these gaming cons where all of the gaming folks are at, You will be able to get special things from Cloud Imperium if you show them your card.
That's pretty cool.
Yes.
Yeah, mine went straight into my wallet.
Mine's stuck on the top of my monitor here.
All right, partition editor. Let's see, for now we're going to call this bulk. Gravel, dirt, cobble, what else?
Alright, I'm going to go and watch a little bit of the hockey finals and I'll be back in a bit.
Alrighty.
See ya.
We can add lots and lots of cactus.
What was that?
No, I'm just talking to myself, talking to my
viewers.
Talking to my viewers.
Got it.
Because I'm just in the habit after a year of doing this to where silence is very painfully obvious. Okay. This again for the third time. Okay. So now all of the cobble and all the dirt and gravel and all that junk that I put in there should go into here. And that should provide my bulk storage needs for the time being. That way the 1Ks don't get filled up with a whole ton of crap before they get filled up with different item types. So, let's... test it out. $897 used. Let's go ahead and get a bunch of those. There we go. Working as intended. So now it's just going to be a matter of... Yeah, woohoo! Now it's just going to be a matter of cleaning up all the storage junk that I've got here. Got to make a few input buses as well. Cool. Alright, we will be back in a bit. Alright, so what I'm going to do is, I've moved a few things over already. I'm going to finish moving out all this junk, and I had no idea that I had cobble in almost every possible container in this facility. But, I'm going to make some more cable, and what we're going to do is we're just going to connect everything. So this furnace will output charcoal instead of going straight into this, it's going to go into my ME system, and then the ME system will provide the charcoal back to the steam boiler, and then we'll be able to get rid of at least some of this stuff. Probably end up putting the furnace down here and just running ME cable, but then I still have to decide on what to do with this. I imagine that when I get everything hooked up, I'm going to need more power generation, so I will probably fill out more, just make some more engines, sit around, wait for some steel, and make some industrial engines, and hook up another boiler over here, and make this one the liquid boiler. So we'll just do, may do that off camera, may do it on camera. Probably we'll build a few more of these as well, because those are just cool. And these turned out to not be quite as cool as I'd thought. The furniture lanterns, or I guess that's what they're from. But because you've got to actually take them off the hooks to light them. And they only run for 30 minutes, so I haven't actually... Yeah, like this one's... I mean, I guess we could leave that sitting like that, and it would burn for half an hour and then go out anyway. So I just haven't really bothered with setting up to use those on a regular basis. But now that we've got this one that kind of runs all by itself, we are definitely going to be using this. I wonder if you can... Ooh, cool. Oh, very, very cool. You can pretty much put it on any... It orients to any surface. So, there we go. And we'll have some more of these next time. So, thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. And we'll see y'all next time. Bye-bye.